starring June Lockhart, Hugh Riley, John Provost as Timmy, and, of course, Lassie.
And here we see the police officers parading their dogs. These well-trained animals are part of a specialized unit used to combat crime. They are male German shepherds between the ages of 14 months and 2 years when they're first taken in for training. Now, all the dogs are carefully selected for intelligence, health, and the ability to adjust themselves to police techniques. Now, here we see one of the officers taking his dog over the hurdles.
Lassie, shh. It's only a movie.
Now, in these shots, you can see what a fleeing criminal has to face when he's trying to get away from a trained dog. All the shepherds are trained to respond to voice and hand signals. And in these scenes, you can see how well they work. At last comes graduation day, a proud moment for the dog in training.
Anne, will you and Timmy pull up the blinds, please?
Lassie, wait for me out in front.
Uncle Ben, I'm sure I speak for all of us when I tell you how interesting that was. And children, I'm sure you all appreciate Mr. Carter coming here to show you the film.
Yeah.
Now, if there are any questions, I know my uncle would be happy to answer them. Timmy?
Mr. Carter, I was wondering, where do the dogs come from?
Well, most of them are donated by private citizens. Some of them are purchased from breeders.
Oh, perhaps the children would like to hear some of your own experiences before you left the police force. Mr. Carter was on the police force for almost 20 years.
Amy, it's getting a little late.
Mr. Carter, do you still have your own dog?
No, son. Sarge was killed.
Oh.
Well, Mr. Carter does have things to do. Perhaps we'd better let him go. Maybe he'll come and speak to us another time.
You've been a wonderful audience, and I want to thank you for letting me come to talk with you.
All right, there'll be a 10-minute recess. Timmy.
Yes, ma'am?
Would you come here a minute, please?
Yes, Miss Haslett?
Timmy, I suppose you know Mr. Carter has moved here permanently.
Yes, ma'am. He's about a mile from our place.
Yes, I know. And Timmy, he's a very lonely man. Since he was wounded and he retired from duty, he doesn't have too much to look forward to. And most of all, I guess he misses his dog, Sarge.
Hush. I know how he feels.
Well, that's why I thought maybe you and Lassie could be friends of his.
We'd like that. Can I help you with that?
Oh, that's all right. I can manage.
Timmy and Lassie are neighbors of yours, Uncle Ben.
Well, hello, Timmy.
Hi.
Hi, Lassie.
I hope Lassie didn't bother you in the schoolroom. It was the first time she's ever seen a movie.
Not at all. She was a very good listener.
I was hoping we could come visit you someday. We passed right by your house coming home from school every day.
Well, Timmy,
I know you're busy and all, but we wouldn't be much bother, would we?
All right, Timmy.
Gee, thanks.
Well, Amy? Bye, Timmy. Bye, Lassie.
Bye, Uncle Ben, and thanks again. All right, children, let's go back to school.
Lassie, can you wait for me out by the gate? And don't come back to that window. Boy, that cake was swell.
I guess you're too young to decide what you want to do when you grow up, huh?
Well, I haven't thought much about it. But after seeing those pictures the other day, I might be a policeman. Because I like to work with dogs like you did. I bet your dog, Sarge, was great.
He sure was. Sarge was a good friend, just like your Lassie, dear. He was the smartest dog. He understood every word I said. He could almost talk.
Well, maybe you could get another dog someday.
You don't find dogs like Sarge very often. Even if I did, I don't think I'd have the patience to train another dog. Would you like to see his picture?
Sure. He sure was a beauty.
He sure was. He died saving my life.
Well, we better be going now. Is it okay if we come back another day?
Why, anytime, Timmy. You promised to bring Lassie with you.
I promised to come. How about it? Well, bye.
Bye.
Come on, Lassie.
From what you tell me, our new neighbor must be quite a man.
He sure is, Mom. But he seems kind of lonely, though. I sure wish there was something I could do for him.
Like what, son?
I don't know exactly. But you know Mr. Dinsmore down by Mills Valley?
The man who has the kennels.
Uh-huh. Well, Lassie and I went down to visit him about a week ago. And he has this white German Shepherd. Looks almost like Sarge. I was thinking, if I could get him and train him a little and give him to Mr. Carter.
Oh, Timmy, that's a wonderful thought.
But it's not very practical, Timmy. German shepherds are very expensive.
Well, it won't do any harm just to talk to him, would it?
I don't think so.
But you're going to have to be quite a salesman.
Lassie and I can do it, can't we?
What a combination to throw at Mr. Dinsmore.
Oh, morning, Timmy.
I bet German shepherds cost an awful lot, don't they?
Oh, more than even I like to pay, I'll tell the world.
Supposing a fellow wanted to buy one, about how much would he need?
Oh, good one, up to $300.
$300?
Yeah. One not so good, maybe you could get for $100. How come you're looking for another dog?
It's for a friend. He used to have one, like that one. I guess he'd really cost a lot, wouldn't he?
It's a matter of plain fact. That dog is worth nothing.
But why?
He's the only one of the litter that wasn't up to par. It'd take a lifetime to train.
I've got a lot of time.
You know, maybe you just could do something. It'd take an awful lot of patience.
Oh, I've got lots of that.
Well, I guess that's good enough for me. Okay, boy, the dog is yours.
Gee, thanks a million. Did you hear that, boy? Come on.
See what I mean?
Maybe I better call him by his name. Does he have one?
None that I know of. Useless would sure be a fitting one, though.
Then I'm going to call him Little Sarge.
Well, I guess any name's as good as another. Well, I wish you luck, Little Sarge. Now on, you're going to have somebody that'll spend some time with you. Here you are, boy. Remember, boy, don't forget what I told you about patience. That dog's going to take plenty of it.
I will. Thanks a million, Mr. Dinsmore. Look, Mom. Mr. Dinsmore gave him to me.
Gave him to you?
Uh-huh. Honest, for nothing. He couldn't make him do anything. And after I explained about Mr. Carter and Sarge, well, he just gave him to me. But Lassie and I are going to train him, aren't we, Sarge?
Oh, you've named him already.
Sure. And Little Sarge is an A-plus name. Mr. Carter will sure be surprised. After Little Sarge gets used to us, we're going to start training. Well, come on. We'll show you around the farm. Come on, Lassie. Sarge, now we're going to start with you training. Now, you pay attention. Now sit, boy. Sit. Sit, little Sarge. You watch Lassie, and then maybe you can understand. Sit, Lassie. See how easy it is? Now sit. Guess you have to know as much as Mr. Carter to train police dogs. Hey, I've got an idea. Come on, Lassie. You stay here, little Sarge. We don't want Mr. Carter to find out about the secret. Come on, girl. So you see, Mr. Carter, I'm going to do a composition on how to train police dogs.
Well, basic training's the same for all dogs, Timmy. It's only when you get into training for police work that it becomes more specialized.
Well, even in basic training, isn't there something different you have to do with police dogs?
Well, you might handle the training leash differently. Shepherds are short-haired dogs.
Training leash?
It's a short chain collar. Wait a minute. I've got one inside. I'll show it to you.
I'll bet this is just what we need.
Here it is, Timmy.
Is this one you use to train Sarge with?
Sure is.
How does it work?
Here, I'll show you. You hold it like this. Then, for instance, you command the dog to heel. Now, if he doesn't stop, pull him up like this. And make him stay right next to you. After four or five times, he'll understand the command. And he'll know that if he doesn't obey, he'll get his neck jerked. The same thing goes for other commands like sit and lie down and so forth.
Seems easy enough. Could I borrow it?
Well, sure, Timmy. But what for?
Well, I think I can show it when I give my report, and some pictures and things. And that way, Miss Hazel will give me a better grade.
Well, if it's that important to you, Timmy, you're welcome to it. Here.
Gee, thanks. We'll bring it back.
Anytime, Timmy. I enjoy your company. Yours and Lassie's.
Well, we better be going. So long.
So long.
Heel, Sarge. When I say heel, I mean to stop. Heel! 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 Sarge! Heel! Heel!
I'll just be a minute, Timmy.
Okay, Dad.
Like there's a lot more wrong with him than we thought, Timmy. I think we better pay a visit to the vet. Come on.
Come on, little Sarge. Come on, Lassie. Easy, boy.
The dog is deaf, Paul.
Can you fix it, Doc?
Oh, an operation might work, but I couldn't guarantee anything.
Timmy, that would be too expensive. We can't afford to...
Oh, Paul. After hearing what Timmy is trying to do to help Mr. Carter, let's say that this one is on the house.
Gee, thanks. When can you start?
Well, would tomorrow be too soon?
Oh.
Hey,
he all right, Doctor?
I've done what I could, Timmy. Little Sarge will have to stay here for a few more days.
Will he be all right? Will he be able to hear again?
Frankly, I don't know. His hearing might come back slowly. Maybe suddenly. Maybe not at all. Don't get your hopes up.
I know he'll be all right. Because you're the best doctor in the whole world.
Well, with that kind of faith, I guess there isn't much more for me to say, is there?
Thanks, Doctor. Come on.
It's been 3 days now, and little Sarge still can't hear.
Well, the vet said he couldn't guarantee anything to me. You've got to remember that.
Come on now, Timmy. You've got a Cub Scout meeting to get to. I'm sure the boys are very anxious to see those new rope tricks you've taught Lassie.
Okay, Mom. We'll only be gone a couple hours, little Sarge. Don't forget to give him the pills the vet gave us.
No, dear. I won't.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Sarge.
Little Sarge went after him.
Good work, Little Sarge.
Is it dead?
Yeah, he's dead.
How do you suppose Little Sarge knew the coyote was out here?
Dad, do you suppose that Little Sarge heard the coyote?
More than likely, he smelled the coyote to me.
I've got an idea. Hold Little Sarge, Mom. Come on, girl. Here, Sarge. Come on, Sarge. Come on, boy.
It is.
Now I can train him and give him to Mr. Carter, can't I, Dad?
Well, I don't see why not.
Gee, thanks.
But not tonight. Come on now, it's time for bed.
Little Sarge, I want you to pay attention. Watch this. Okay, now sit, Little Sarge. Sit up. Okay, Little Sarge. Now lie down. Now roll over, Little Sarge. Roll over, Little Sarge. I said roll over. Little Sarge, roll over. Thank you. Uncle Sarge. Why didn't you do that in the first place? Pick it up. Pick it up. Now take it over to Mr. Carter.
Thanks, boy.
We named him Little Sarge, Mr. Carter. He's all yours.
I don't know what to say, Timmy.
I expect he'll need an awful lot of training before he's anything like your Sarge. But he's a quick learner.
I've learned a lesson, too, Timmy. There's nothing like having friends. Especially if it's a boy and his dog.
We did it, girl.